Recently, there's been a lot of discussion about omega-3 supplements and whether we need to take them on a plant-based diet. I think it's really important we research this topic thoroughly, as omega-3s help to maintain the functioning of every cell membrane in our body. They also act as gatekeepers to the cell and regulate the passage of both nutrients and waste products across the cell membrane. Omega-3s also promote signalling between cells by providing the structure and connection to cell membrane receptors. They're such an important part of our cells' metabolism that the molecules are consumed quickly, and our cells therefore need a regular supply of omega-3 molecules. Omega-3s also balance and neutralise the pro-inflammatory omega-6s that we consume. Omega-3 is a family of at least 15 different fat molecules. Some of the main ones are EPA, DHA, and ALA. ALA, alpha-linolenic acid, is a short-chain omega-3 fatty acid and is found in many plant foods, including flaxseeds. In theory, our body can elongate the short-chain ALA from flaxseeds into the longer-chain omega-3s. So can we meet all our omega-3 needs from eating just flaxseeds? Well, let's hear now from Dr. Michael Greger and Dr. Joel Furman. Links to the original videos are in the description below.
Can sufficient DHA levels be achieved through flaxseeds without supplementing? That is a good question. That is an unanswered question. There are short-chain omega-3 fatty acids found in whole healthy plant foods like flaxseeds and walnuts and a little bit in dark green leafy vegetables and hemp seeds. And our body can take those short-chain fatty acids called alpha-linolenic acid and elongate them into the long-chain fatty acids, the so-called marine fatty acids like EPA and DHA, which you find in fish fats. You can make EPA, DHA. The question is, can you make enough for optimal health? Particularly if you're pregnant and you're actually making enough for two people. And I am concerned enough about the potential cognitive detriment of having insufficient DHA, particularly later in life, particularly in men, that I encourage people to consider supplementing with preformed EPA, DHA in, and you can retroconvert from DHA to EPA, so you can just take DHA if you want, from pollutant-free sources, meaning algae or yeast-based sources, rather than fish, which is too contaminated in terms of mercury and some of the things you cannot distill out of fish oil, some of the other toxic pollutants. And so then you can get preformed DHA, and still good to take, eat flax seeds for their cancer benefits from lignans, etc. But the answer to the question is maybe, but kind of as an insurance policy, I encourage people to get preformed until we know different. And if you're like, wait a second, what evidence do you have to support that? I lay it out. Type in DHA and nutritionfacts.org, and then you will know as much as I do. And I've taken that body of research and decided that there's evidence enough for me to do it, my family to start doing it. But you can look at that same evidence and be like, no way, I'm not going to do that until we have stronger evidence. That would be a legitimate conclusion as well.
I am constantly taking this role, and I don't relish this role as being the contrarian here, you know. But the point is that I want to make sure that nobody gets messed up. As you know, as 30 years taking care of this community, I've seen too many people get in trouble when people are following cookbook advice, the same advice for each person, and they get into trouble, and you do blood work, and you figure out what's wrong, and you try to fix them. Why do they need to get into trouble? Once the brain shrinks, it doesn't come back again. You can't then give them the DHA supplement. DHA and B12 deficiency can result, and even zinc insufficiency in some vegans can result in things that are dangerous enough that can be continually harmful to their lives. First of all, when we study vegan populations who are not supplementing with a DHA supplement, the Nutritional Research Foundation funded a study where we had 166 non-supplementing vegans, and they were eating relatively healthy diets with walnuts, flax seeds, green vegetables, not the use of oils. And we found that 67% or two-thirds were insufficient in the omega-3 index and in DHA levels. We found about 25% had adequate levels, and about 25% had extremely dangerously low levels that would have clearly led to a significant problem like dementia. Generally speaking, the majority of people who follow a vegan diet don't have enough of the conversion enzyme genetically to assure DHA adequacy. You could check that with these blood tests. You could do it at a standard lab and get an omega-3 quantitative index level and DHA level, and you can get your DHA level and your omega-3 index. Generally, you consider that DHA index and omega-3 index above 5 is okay. In our study, we considered above 4 okay, just to give people the benefit of the doubt. Below 4, you know that you're in trouble, because below 3.5 in scientific studies is associated with clearly brain shrinkage and increased dementia with aging. So even though a high-nutrient vegan diet decreases the risk of depression and dementia from the high phytochemical intake, low phytochemical and low micronutrients are just one cause of dementia. Even with a high intake of phytochemicals and phytonutrients, which can decrease dementia and depression in the general population, still could create dementia and depression in a population that's well-nourished just due to the deficiency of those fatty acids alone. So there's multiple causes of dementia and depression, and we can't just pick the one cause we want to talk about, because we have to make sure that we do all this. So yes, you can do a blood test. You can supplement with these things conservatively. We have to recommend the responsible supplementation, so people on vegan diets or near vegan diets are not taking chances with developing some problems that could manifest themselves later on in life. You can't really check it once they're taking the supplement, because we find that almost all people taking the supplement do have adequate levels. So let's see, if you don't want to get checked, you have to do it without, before you're taking the supplements, or just take the supplements. And so it's a really minority of people that have adequate levels and don't require anything. So even if they don't get checked, you have to err on the side of caution.
Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, and subscribe for more upcoming videos.